Neighborhood Health Watch is sponsored by the doctors of HCA Virginia Health System.
The topic today in Neighborhood Health Watch is cervical spinal stenosis. It's a common condition sometimes referred to as pinched nerve. In spinal stenosis, the spinal canal narrows and can squeeze the nerve roots. Most neck pain is due to degenerative changes that occur in the spine and joints. Perhaps the most serious problem, of course, is the condition of spinal stenosis. And joining us today to talk more about it is Dr. Adam Crowl with Parham Doctors Hospital. Thank you for joining us on First at 4. First question, is spinal stenosis the same as pinched nerve? One sounds more serious than the other.
It does, and as we were discussing before, cervical spinal stenosis sounds very formal. Mm-hmm. For most patients that have symptoms of a true pinched nerve, oftentimes they have spinal stenosis.
And show us what goes on in a person's body, if you can, with you
brought yes, ma'am.
A prop here today. What's happening when you have that condition?
Sure. Spinal stenosis is narrowing of the spinal canal where the spinal cord itself lives, as well as the little branches where the nerves come out and go down your arms. And what in this model, we're showing the back of the spine is those bony things that you mm-hmm. touch in the back. That's the roof of the spinal canal. But all of the discs actually live right behind your throat. Very much here in the front. And what the model was kind of showing is how the nerves come off of the spinal cord behind that to go down the arms.
And this is a condition that if all of us live long enough, we will have. It's inevitable.
Yes, ma'am. If we're fortunate to live into our fourth and fifth and sixth decades, most of us will develop spinal stenosis for sure. If it becomes symptomatic, not everybody will, but when it does, we can make it better.
Explain the difference between rotator cuff problems and cervical spinal stenosis.
Yes, ma'am. Very, very common. A lot of patients that have symptoms of a pinched nerve, they'll have pain in the shoulder. It may even go down the upper arm a bit, but they're not really getting much pain in their neck. Mm-hmm. And they're confused as to who they should see. The easiest way to figure it out at home is that if you can raise your arm up above your head and it makes the pain better, that's a pinched nerve. If the pain seems to worsen if you do that, that's probably your shoulder.
Oh, very good.
Sure.
Very good. And treatment, what are the treatment
options?
Yes,
ma'am. Certainly we try some of the conservative things first to reduce inflammation and nerve root irritation. However, there are lots of patients that if they have isolated compression at one or two levels, we can do a minimally invasive surgery, remove the disc and bone spur and the pressure on the nerve, have patients stay overnight and get back to regular activities in just a few weeks.
All right, I just diagnosed my condition, pinched nerve.
Happy to see you.
Thank you, Dr. Crowl, for joining us.
Yes,
we appreciate it.
Yes, ma'am.
Heather?